Quaife?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
US?
Yep.
UK?
US or UK?
UK.
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 The same as Orion?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Same. Definitely has a Quaife in there. Rich, that's why. Rich man.
That was crazy.
Yeah.
Eating. All right.
Closer look at this ITR that's actually from Hong Kong. Brought the car all the way out here to compete, so it's very interesting to see. The left-hand drive appears to be a US ITR with a JDM ITR face, K24 swap, no motor, custom dash. Check that side, the window's open. It's got a custom dash. It's got a PDM. Oh, that shifter. S15 Naito Motorsports. So we're running an SR.
Turbo upgrade.
This looks like the engine's been moved. On it. 1817 stagger. Yeah, 1816. Four lug in the rear, very traditional, and then five lug in the front. Really cool car. Very grassroots, very traditional, old school Japanese style of tuning. The tape on yourself?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Very old school. You want me to hold it there while you get tape?
Good.
Yeah. another tail light?
Yeah. Well, I didn't even have tail lights on.
Oh, just a shell?
That's illegal at World Contact.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you have to run Au-Yeung tail lights at World Contact. So we actually brought them to Australia and switched them because the car went into the shipping container with the carbon still on it. So we bought this in our check-in.
Oh, it did have carbon ones on it before.
Yeah. And then we just put it on the track.
So you just have to have like hazards just in case?
Or this event.
Oh, okay.
But nobody uses it. You know, we read the rules. Like, it's like they require headlights, so we put headlights on.
Oh, oh yeah.
But
yeah. Official.
That's cool. That's like these things, right?
Yeah. Just like keep them on there forever type of thing.
They say, yeah.
Like badges of honor.
Shows how dumb or stupid or actually brilliant I am.
Yeah, right?
A mix of everything.
I think it takes a little bit of both to be brilliant.
Yeah.
So there's a little bit of craziness and brilliance, right?
I would totally agree with that. I mean, like, the effort it takes, you know, talking to Z, you know, we're both trying to make all the arrangements to get here.
Yeah.
And we both had that exact, like, this is a pain. This is way harder than probably either of us expected.
Yeah.
When we were, you know, getting involved in this.
Yeah.
But you gotta do it. You gotta take that chance.
Yeah, right.
How do you know where you stack up? How do you know, this is where it started. This is it. This is the
real world stage,
right?
Yeah.
How many times have I done a lap in Gran Turismo here? Like, it's crazy.
How does it feel? Is it the same?
It's actually a really tough track to go.
Yeah.
It seems so simple, like, you know, you watch a lap, it's like, bam, I can figure that out in, like, 5 minutes.
Yeah.
But every corner is very unique. You know, turn one is actually a really long corner. Play it in a game or you simulate or you watch a video, it doesn't seem like it seems like a hairpin.
Yeah.
But it's not, it's really a long sweeper. But it's got a braking zone of a hairpin, which adds a dynamic into it because you're coming in with the highest speed on the track basically. And you have to nail this braking zone. But you also have to carry that momentum through a fairly long corner and not make a mistake. So on that last session actually, I ended up looping my back end and again, it catches you out by surprise because it felt perfect. Like that entry, I was like, I nailed this fly.
Yeah.
And I'm just going in and it's like taking forever and it just starts to rotate. It's like, are you kidding? So the learning experience is definitely huge. Which then makes you timid because you come back the next time and you're like, oh, I gotta take it easier.
Yeah.
But I think this track, you gotta be aggressive. So definitely gonna be some fun times. The times are gonna drop. Both me and Adam, we have buckets of time left.
Hey Aaron. So after the super lap, I'll probably come in the back entrance.
Okay.
Because I gotta line up in pit lane.
Okay.
Yeah.
You might have to nose it so we can put the fan on.
Yeah, I'll nose it into here.
Just do one hot one. If you have to do two, but it depends on how you decide. Okay?
Yeah. Yes,
do
one.
When I first got a hold of Daiyogi, or Daitsuki Aoki from Attack, I think he's like, you're nuts. Like, you know, the first thing is, you have no idea, right?
Yeah.
But as that conversation went in, I was like, no, I want to do this. You know, I want to come here. Mm-hmm. I want to compete. I want to do it on proper terms. I'm not, you know, no freebies here. Just tell me what needs to be done, and I want to be here.
Mm-hmm.
And I think you earn a little bit of respect from that. It's like,
oh yeah,
you know, I just want to be here. I want to be part of the culture. I want to be an entrant just like anybody else is up and down the strip. Way better. Didn't make many mistakes. Entry into corner two was a little maybe a little over all over the place, but the rest of the track was like really good. I'd be happy with that. Last corner, there's definitely a slingshot that I need to use.
Thank you. Well done.
Keep bringing it.
Yeah.
Elevate each other.
Going, holding steady. 54-0.
54-0 something.
There you go.
Breaking into a different spot. I'm still trying to find my way, right?
Yep.
So I think ultimately, seat time might be one of the most valuable things that we have.
Yeah. And it's like, when are you gonna get to come back and do this again, you know?
Yeah.
Might as well have fun with it, so.
Thank you.
53.299.
What was it?
53.299.
Wow.
And Taniguchi is here to hang out. Congratulations. I guess that was the one, huh?
That was still mistakes. Still mistake I won. Just on entry, I kind of overbroke it, but then I made the corner, and then instead of like just letting it go, I kind of like tried a little too hard.
Yeah.
But the exit was really good. Getting into two, probably the best I've taken it so far. Really carried the momentum through three into four. For sure, again, the best I've done. I like actually broke too deep there, so actually started, I locked up the rear and then started hopping.
So you're trying to dip into the 52s, you think?
The potential's there.
Yeah.
But it's hard to put a lap together. Like, it really, it's like I was saying before.
Yeah.
Like, the difference between good and great and excellent, it's like you make a little bobble here and there, and it's, each bobble's over a tenth of a second.
Yeah.
Like, for sure. So.
It's way more technical than it looks, right?
Gratifying being here, because you know what the greats have been here.
Yeah, there's a great right here. Just hanging out. Oh, Taniguchi was just
there. Taniguchi was just right there.
Yeah.
And for him to come by and congratulate me, that's exceptional.
It's worth the ticket, right?
it really is. So, yeah, really feeling it. Heart feels great. It is blowing a little bit coolant, so we're gonna, I don't know what we're gonna do for the last session.
You still have an entire day, you know that, right?
that's the thing. This isn't even the event.
Yeah, you still have an entire day to reset your own record, so it's got to be a great feeling, though. Congratulations. Yeah, we're alive. Yeah, yeah. About 3:30 p.m. now. The guys from JDMYARD just changed the head gasket on their Civic. The head gasket went out early this morning, but they kept driving on it. They're just making really good time, but now with Will breaking the Tsukuba record, we're gonna see what JDMYARD car can do in full strength, more boost. See how things go. Hopefully it stays competitive. day one. Practice day. New lap record. And now Garage Work is here to join in on the fun. So we'll see how this thing does tomorrow. Should be pretty interesting. Look how it has TRD sport wheels in the back. Just to be chilling at Tsukuba Circuit, watching, get ready for the next day. Bucket list, I guess you could say. Something that I never thought I'd actually do, but here we are at Tsukuba. I'm glad you guys are here to witness it, because it's quite a sight. Can't say I've ever been to Coco's in the U.S., but Yossi swears that Coco's in the U.S. is not as good as the one in Japan, so we're gonna try it. Also because we have like 30 people with us, and there isn't a place in Japan that could reasonably seat like 30 fucking people for dinner, so. Coco's it is. Got fish?
This one?
Dude, this is
miso fish.
Miso fish.
Yeah, with
Saba?
Mine's a big one. This one's good.
I don't know. I got mine.
Just rice?
Yep, it's not a diet. Yeah.
Yeah, diet.
There you go.
I ordered a big rice. That's the same size as the regular one.
To be able to do this is...
Yeah, it's like a rewarding experience in itself, right?
It is. I don't want to say a dream come true. It's one of those things that you don't even dream about. It's
yeah.
Like, wow, really?
It's like something on your bucket list that you didn't know was on your bucket list.
Yeah. Because you don't think it's possible.
Yeah.
I think even building a time attack car, you don't think it's possible. Right?
Yeah.
You don't get into something that you're really passionate about because you're thinking, I'm going to be the best. I'm aiming to be the best at it.
Mm.
You normally get it because you just love doing it.
Yeah.
I would say that probably with you.
Yeah.
Where you got into it because it's a way for you to outlet
mm-hmm.
and express a certain side of it that you just can't say by words.
Yeah.
Pictures, videos, and space.
Yeah. The experience is a reward. Yeah.
So, and I would say like that, you know, it really started out being a very passionate thing.
Mm-hmm.
And that's great about time attack is, no two cars here are alike.
Yeah.
And I mean no two cars here are alike.
Yeah.
Even if they're the same make and model, they're not alike.
Yeah.
Which is ultimately, you know, it's not like you give 10 people a steak and you're gonna get 10 steaks that are pretty damn close to one another.
Yeah.
Here it's like everybody just has a different way of making it, right?
Yeah.
And I love that side of time attack. It's an expression of yourself.
Yeah, exactly.